started by making an oval shape and then adding features to this face. Though it is a side face, so I added the nose, lips, and now I'm making the eyes, which is slightly slanting. Because it is a miniature painting or a traditional Rajasthani painting, the eyes and the features should be a little sharp. I'm making the eyelids and eyebrows will be slightly into a more curved shape, which is slightly moving a little up as you can see in the picture. Now, because there is a little less head space, I will erase a little upper part and make sure that my head becomes slightly big, giving details to the lips. If you can see, I'm just extending a little bit of head so that I can make all the jewelry part clearly visible. I'm giving a slight detail for the jewelry part so that when we are coloring it, when we are applying colors, it is easy for us to understand where we actually have to do that. After doing that, I am just adding a layer of line for the dupatta on top of my head, doing the same thing, repeating the same thing on the other side as well. Now, because it is a traditional design, so the jewelry plays a very important part. I'm adding the headgear, jewelry on the head part as well, and adding the details for the hair. After that, I'm just adding a few strands to beautify more for the girl's face, and then adding the earring part, which is called as a jhumki. Make sure you have to draw it very minutely as it is a miniature painting. Now, giving the details to the border of my dupatta by making it a double line. As we are showing that the dupatta is transparent, so a certain part of head is also visible. So I am adding the backside of the head along with the bun. Then continuing my dupatta line around the bun and falling it down. I started by making the neck now. Again, there should be a little gap between the chin part and the neckline. So just make sure to start the neck from where I have started. Again, the back side of the neck is also slightly visible, so make sure to make the shoulder as well as the neck so that it is easy for the body to form a perfect shape. I'm extending a little slanting line for the shoulder and the upper part of the hand. Now I'm making the blouse line. Make sure not to extend the upper part of the body too much down and make it little proportionate as shown in the drawing. The fold of the hand and the upper part of the body, make sure the gap between both of them should be a little less so that you get a proportionate picture of the hand. I'm making the blouse lines again. I'm making double lines because I will be adding a lot of design into those things. Just marking the necklace so that while we are painting, it is easy for us to follow the pencil lines and we not make a mistake while doing the detailed part of the neckline, the necklace. I'm making the extension of the back side of the dupatta onto the shoulder. Again, I am crossing the front line of the dupatta so that, as I told you earlier also, that the dupatta is transparent, so the borders will be quite visible. Extending the back side of the dupatta a little more to give a complete look for the whole body. If you see, I have erased a certain part of the front part of the hand so that my palm and the fingers will come proportionate and it won't look odd. Now I'm making the fingers, which are slightly pointed on the tip. If you've seen, I have taken from the little finger, I have taken a slight curve for the palm and then attached it to the front part of the hand. I'm now adding details of the jewelry on the hand so that it is easy for me again to follow the placements of the jewelry and give details to that. The other hand is holding the dupatta, so I am making it like a folded hand, holding the dupatta. Make sure the stomach line should be equal to the folded part of the hand so that you get the best proportion of the body. Now I'm making the skirt or the lehenga part of the girl. I I will extend it till the end of the paper. And completing the rest of the part of the dupatta which is visible to me. For the back hand, I am just making the fingers holding the dupatta in the way as shown in the drawing. By making two fingers together, the other two fingers holding the back side of the dupatta. If you notice, there is a slight bend in the hand, in the fingers. Again, the fingers, the tip of the fingers should be pointed. Adding the rest of the details of the hand by putting the jewelry part, the bangles and everything. Now, because the girl is holding a bird, a pigeon, I will be starting from the top part of the hand. So that I get the perfect position of the bird, as you see in the drawing. Making the wing of the bird and then making a flare of the tail, just like a fan shape.